Welcome back, everyone, to Wednesday Night Lights. Happy JERSDAY to all who observe. I'm Luke Martin alongside Sebastian Dimter, Kyron Ross, and Jack Hartford. We got a great show today. College football, the NFL, college hoops are back. College basketball is back.
Yep.
Lot to talk about, and I think we should just hop right into it. We'll start last week, the college football week 10. Before we get into any of the games, some more sign-stealing info came out. Turns out Michigan isn't the big bad instigator who we thought they were, you know?
Yeah.
Would anyone like to retract any statements they made?
No.
It's never a massive
I'm with Michigan. I don't like Michigan, but I'm with them right now.
You know, honestly, I like Michigan way more than most other schools, so.
Okay, yeah.
I think later on, everyone in the Big Ten is going to be, found out.
Except for Iowa.
Except for Illinois, obviously. We got Brett Bielema.
I don't know.
Yeah, you guys don't have to worry about stealing signs because you guys are not good.
All right. Yeah, most fraudulent 7-2 team of all time.
November 18th.
November
18th. Put your money where your mouth is.
Yep.
I will.
All I'm saying. But yeah, so it came out. Ohio State ratted on Michigan. Michigan saw that and they were like, okay. Yeah, Connor Stallions was up to some naughty, no good stuff, but not with our knowledge. And now we're going to make you guys pay for it. It turns out Ohio State and Rutgers gave the decoded Michigan signs to Purdue for the Big Ten title game. If you don't remember those three teams when they played Michigan last year, first half, they outscored Michigan 50-45. In the second half, Michigan outscored them 95-12, I believe. So make of that what you will. I'm not gonna push any specific narrative there, but yeah, there's something going on. Michigan's making adjustments in the second half, and they're the best at it. Jim Harbaugh is the still second best coach behind Kirby Smart. I would love to give Jim Harbaugh that 1-1 spot, but Kirby Smart has really, big win over Mizzou. And he beat Mizzou in a week where, Mizzou outplayed him for three quarters, and that game really came down to just Kirby Smart doing his thing late, Missouri kind of self-sabotaging, but we can talk about that later.
I'm excited to see Jim Harbaugh on the Bears in the future.
Oh, me too. I am so excited. As soon as this year's over, Jim Harbaugh collects his natty right to the NFL. That's my hot take.
Hopefully.
Yeah,
the Bears.
Hopefully. We could use that. You hope not. Why?
Yeah, why?
What's the guy's name? I can't think of his name. Chiefs, former offensive coordinator.
Matt Nagy.
Now Commanders offensive coordinator.
Oh, Bieniemy.
Yeah, I want Bieniemy so bad. He will turn Justin Fields into...
Okay.
I don't disagree with that.
That's right. Yeah,
counterpoint. I like that take a lot. Eric Bieniemy might be one of the best No, D'Amico Ryans is a better coach than Bieniemy. But Bieniemy is up there. Counterpoint, Jim Harbaugh took Colin Kaepernick to a Super Bowl. And Justin Fields is better than Colin Kaepernick.
Kaepernick? I will stick by this. Kaepernick was not bad.
He was awful.
He was not bad.
He was awful.
He was.
He had one decent season. He's awful.
No,
he sucks.
His hair was awesome.
He was he was just like a Walmart Cam Newton.
And he was good at what he did.
Nah, dollar store.
He had a rocket arm.
Correct.
Way above average in speed.
Okay, Justin Fields fits both of those categories.
No.
Yes.
Kaepernick's arm was 100 times better than Fields' arm. All right. And I'll stand by that.
It's some good college football talk.
Crazy. Okay.
We'll
move
on. We'll do it later.
Okay. Yeah. So since Sebastian wants to talk about college football, Notre Dame minute. Go.
don't even want to talk about it. It was never our season. Sam Hartman was never the answer.
keep going.
Yeah. He's thrown like 8 picks in the last 4 games. Kind of ridiculous, honestly. Yeah.
Did you peep our TikTok that I posted?
Yeah, I did. Don't want to talk about that either. I got to say, MVP of the game was the Clemson punter for pinning us inside the 10 for 5 straight drives. Very impressive. Nothing else to say. Notre Dame, that was pathetic, and I'm excited for our future, though.
Remember when all you guys were like, hey, you are delusional if you think Clemson stands a chance when I originally picked Clemson, and I got bombarded with mean comments from my colleagues. I should have trusted my gut.
We
know I have the best takes. I picked Bedlam right. Did I not? I picked Bedlam right. Went against the crowd. I said C.J. Stroud was going to be the best quarterback in his draft class. He's going to win an MVP in his rookie year, okay?
Yeah.
I picked UConn to win it all last year.
I did.
I picked Joel Embiid to win MVP last year. You did not pick UConn.
Yes, I did. I swear to God, I did.
No, you definitely picked Creighton. You definitely picked Creighton.
No.
You're such an Illinois.
You're such All
right. All right. Okay, okay.
Here's what I'll say, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Notre Dame, Sam Hartman, transferred for a reason. He transferred so he could play for a better school. But
he transferred so he could play one more year.
True.
Yeah.
But he also needed to play for a better school to get the recognition he deserved.
True. I mean, he was turning heads at Wake Forest, but...
Wake Forest isn't big
enough. I'd say he probably...
Should have just went to the draft.
Yeah, I mean, early on, like after the Ohio State game, I was like, okay, maybe this was a good fit for him, but... I feel like he started to tank his stock.
Would you say his stock is down now?
I would say it's starting to... The Notre Dame experiment probably wasn't the best for Sam Hartman.
It's kind of like when you put your money in stock, and then the stock catches on fire.
Economic advice, Kyron Ross.
Yeah.
Stock catches on fire, and then now you're like, well, what am I supposed to do with this?
Okay, speaking of stocks, and I'm going to pull this from a overrated college football coach, but if Clemson's a stock, buy all of it right now.
Yeah, but Dabo Sweeney is
the direct Dabo quote from after the game. That's brutal. You're getting like emoted on by a glorified. He's a glorified youth pastor. He's not a football coach.
Like, yeah. Yep.
I'm sorry, Dabo Sweeney. Good for him. I was all over Clemson fans saying, this is the best you got. This is the best you'll ever have. This is the best you've had. He's won two national championships at a semi-irrelevant school. Like, do not push him out the door because he will go somewhere else and win in your face. And buy that stock. They're going to be better than 6-6 next year, probably.
Just want to shout out really quick. Illinois took a really nice win this past weekend.
Of course.
Shout out John Paddock, our backup quarterback, for going 3-for-3. and like 70 passing yards, game-winning drive, beat Minnesota. We're gonna be a bowl team probably. So happy about it.
3-for-3.
Yep. All
right. Here's what I'll say.
He came in the last drive. That's why he was 3-of-3.
Now I saw a stat the other day. It was, if we're shouting out our teams, it was that Iowa has allowed 248 yards.
Oh, I saw a different stat. That's way better. Okay, go.
They allowed 248 yards in 2 years. My other team, USC, has allowed 254 yards. I messed that up.
That's not possible.
I messed that up really bad. I'll be
right
back. You're
going to say like 250 yards?
Okay, so the stat I saw is if we assume that after a failed third down conversion, the quarterback runs half the distance of the – or he jogs half the distance of the field or half the width of the field off to the sideline. If we assume that and we total it up, Iowa quarterbacks have jogged more yards off the field than Iowa's offense has gained.
I saw that.
Yeah. Wow.
Yep. Yeah.
Yep.
They're both like in the 1100s, which is brutal. Brutal.
Just that's sad. Crazy. Iowa is a Story sad Taylor for Heisman.
If we had an offense even like decent.
I agree.
If we had Mizzou's offense.
I agree.
We would be a top 5 team in the nation.
I agree.
That's why Mizzou's so good though.
Just wait. Until we get a good
quarterback. Okay, but Mizzou's offense is a big ass. Oh. Brady Cook, top 5 quarterback in the SEC. Cody Schrader, dog. I don't know where he stands because SEC running backs are very, very good. We saw that these past couple weeks. But Cody Schrader, for all the short kings out there, 5'9 legend. I think he played D2, transferred in. Luther Burden, best receiver in the country. I will stand by that.
Or second.
Malik Neighbors. Second best, yeah. Neighbors and Harrison Neighbors, Jr. Yeah. We had this discussion already.
Yeah.
Theo East, Mookie Cooper, okay? Yep. A lot of dogs on that Missouri team. That's a great offense right there. That's not even a decent. That's a great offense.
One more thing.
If you had Florida's offense. Actually, no. No.
No, Florida's offense, not much better.
That's a step. That's a lateral step.
All I'm going to say is Brian Ferentz is gone officially.
You've been waiting for this.
Celebration.
I've been waiting my whole life for this. And, you know...
We gotta get the confetti cannons.
Yeah, they usually say it runs in the family, but I guess football does not run in the family with the Ferentzes. He should no longer coach football ever again. So, I know he's gonna stick around, but to all my Iowa fans, you know, you should be happy. You should be grateful that he's
Do
gone.
You think you're done with that family as a whole, though?
No. Kirk is a good coach, in my opinion. I like Kirk.
Yeah, because you did have that one year.
We've
what was
had
it? What, was it 2015 where your offense was
elite.
Like top 10 in the country?
Elite.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
We had Marvin McNutt. Oh, yeah. My God. That offense was disgusting. Okay,
wait, was that, wait, what was the year where you guys went to the Rose Bowl? Didn't you guys go to a Rose Bowl?
We do that all the time.
Wait, what?
The thing is that Iowa has not had a losing season in a very long time.
And they're not going to.
Kirk is the main reason for that, in my opinion. We have not had great rosters where we should be like a winning team, in my opinion. We've had a lot of rosters where it's like, oh, like they're going to be mediocre, but then somehow we end up with like a 9-2 record or something. And I think Kirk's the reason for that. So
Okay. That's an interesting take. I'm not pro or anti it. I'm welcoming it. Rutgers hung around, and I don't know if you caught this, but Boo Corrigan, the president of the College Football Playoff Committee, he said that Rutgers is a quality win for Ohio State. So that's basically a Rutgers win in my eyes. They did not cover. They missed that by half a point, which is unfortunate. But sleeping giant, do not wake up Rutgers. You don't want to see full strength Greg Schiano. Beyond that, Texas. Texas kind of. Can we start a dialogue about this? The Big 12 is bad. Big 12.
Yeah.
I was going to say might be the worst Power 5, but the ACC takes the cake with that just because North Carolina. If North Carolina wasn't doing what they're currently doing, which why are they ranked? They're ranked.
I got to pay attention to college football.
Iowa's ranked.
I was watching the selection 22. Show. I was watching the selection show with my dad, and they show 20 through 25 or whatever, 21 through 25, and I go, two of those teams don't belong. Liberty, I know James Madison isn't allowed to be ranked, but Liberty should be. At least acknowledged.
James Madison should be.
They're not allowed to, though.
It's such garbage. Yeah. I hate it.
I think they put forward some legislature, so maybe.
Yeah, they sent in like a letter.
And I don't know if you guys are history buffs, but when James Madison writes a strongly worded letter, sometimes it works out. All I'm saying.
For watching the History Channel.
JMU also won a basketball game. We'll talk about that later.
Oh, yeah.
But Texas.
So
the Big 12 is not good. Texas is probably the best team there, and that's really not saying much. That win over Bama looks more confusing by the week. Sark's got issues, for sure. And Malik Murphy will be a amazing transfer addition when he inevitably hops in the portal after this year.
I still don't agree, but
I think he should.
I think
he should. The boosters are not going to allow Malik Murphy to start over Arch Manning. That's why I think he should hop in the portal. And there's a school that starts with Ala, ends with Bama, and they kind of need a guy who can throw the ball. All I'm saying.
You know, I also don't think he's crazy good. But
no, I think he's not better than Ewers, but he's up there.
But I also don't think that Arch Manning is better than him. I don't think Arch Manning is very good.
Arch Manning has too much press, though. That's why. They just want him as a quarterback because it kind of like brings – it's almost kind of like the Colorado effect with Deion Sanders where like just brings a lot of like press to the team and stuff because it's, oh, it's Arch Manning.
Yeah.
I would agree, as I was looking at Arch Manning – so you ever been on TikTok and you get like a thing about like this high school quarterback? So I was looking through his stats and through his team.
Okay.
And he was just not – like his stats were good.
Right.
But I think if he – this is going to be a crazy take, but if he played for a team like Downers Grove or anything like that. No, just listen. His stats would not nearly be as good because he plays nobody good.
Yeah, but the thing, you could say that with anybody that goes to a school like IMG where it's like, oh,
but he was in Texas, though.
IMG plays good teams.
But, like, if you take, okay.
Newman doesn't.
I mean, JJ McCarthy.
Oh, wait, Newman's in Louisiana, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's Louisiana.
McCarthy went to Naz. Naz isn't in a massive school like some school in Texas.
But they played Mount Carmel every year. Goodness.
Yeah, yeah. Right. Naz.
So
Naz used to play in good divisions with JJ.
But that was
you calling him out. you calling out the.
I'm not gonna speak.
You calling
about
out
high
the Naz schedule
right
makers.
But, he's still mad because he unfollowed Kyron on Insta.
Yeah. JJ McCarthy is a former follower of Kyron Ross.
All right.
He's too famous for
we're still working on
all
that.
All right, back to Texas.
Yes.
Malik Murphy. He's not the answer for them. Archie Manning's not the
How long is Ewers' timetable?
He's got like 2 more years of eligibility.
No, I'm saying injury.
Oh, I have no clue.
Okay.
You know, I don't pay attention to things like that. I just watch games. But why is Malik Murphy's name spelled like that?
With two A's? Yeah.
Oh.
It's a little confusing.
Strange.
Day-to-day.
Typo on Quinn the Ewers certificate.
Quinn Ewers is day-to-day. Is that true, or are you just saying that?
I'm just saying that.
Okay. It's wild. Let's keep it Big 12. I mentioned it briefly. The Oklahoma State Cowboys won the final bedlam for now. Oklahoma is ending the rivalry with the SEC move next year. One of you, just throw out a guess. What would you say? Okay, actually, no, I'll present it this way. Mike Gundy is the winningest Oklahoma State coach versus Oklahoma all time. Oh, I already did this with you. Kyron.
Okay.
Mike Gundy, winningest Oklahoma State coach versus Oklahoma all time. What is his record over 19 seasons?
Five, four, three, two, one.
12-7.
4-15. Wow. He is the winningest all time because they trail that series 20-91, and there's 7 ties in there. Oklahoma dominates Oklahoma State. This is like a...
Wow.
Yeah, that blew my mind. They kept on showing that stat. I was like, there's no way. And then after they won, they were like, yeah, Mike Gundy is actually the best at this, and he's won 4 times.
That's crazy.
I thought they had Barry Sanders Jr.
I wonder what Mike Gundy's record as a quarterback was against the Sooners. All right, we're going to fact check that. Yep. Sebastian, transition to our next.
All right, so Mizzou.
Gundy never beat Oklahoma. Oh, really? He went 0-4 against the Sooners. That's funny. All right, yeah, Mizzou.
Yeah, so...
What happened?
Yeah.
It's a good question. What
they
did
lost, happen? They played very well to start with that. Came up short against Georgia. Georgia was the better team. What do you got to say about
as
this?
Yeah, Georgia usually is the better team. Yep. It's the SEC.
It's Georgia.
It's going to happen. Georgia hasn't lost in, what, 26 games now? 25 games?
Yeah.
Something ridiculous. It would have been nice for Mizzou to be the one to end that. I mean, back-to-back years, we play them super close. Obviously, this team's a lot better than last year's team. Last year's team barely was bowl eligible. They ended up losing to Wake Forest, and I don't even think Sam Hartman played that game. That's how much of a struggle last year was. But Luther Burden has really come into himself. Brady Cook has matured as a passer. Cody Schrader is Cody Schrader. The defense, I thought the defense was fine.
Yeah, they were fine.
Minus the interception where, like, Brady Cook threw it, like, 4 yards right into the defensive tackle, and he took it, like, whatever, 60 right. yards down to the goal line.
It's like, 2 minutes left in the game.
Yeah, right? Yeah, that was crunch time. Probably, like, 5 minutes left, but still. And then he threw another pick with, like, a minute left. You take that away, I think the defense played an outstanding game. You take those points away, what? Like, we kept them... We kept them in the 20s. That's really all you can do against Georgia, because... Brock Bowers or not, that team is going to score. Ladd McConkey's a dog. Dom Lovett, who was on our side last time these two teams played, he had a touchdown, which, I mean, that revenge game, that should have been free money to whoever took that.
You can't hate on Carson Beck anymore.
I
don't know why
I
didn't think
of that. I can't hate on Carson Beck.
He's actually good.
I think he's fine. He does his job. Missouri's run defense is not the best, but I think their pass defense kind of makes up for it. Carson Beck.
Yeah,
Carson Beck was carving up a little bit. So nothing but complaints to him. I thought he'd throw at least 1 or 2 picks, but he was pretty clean in that game. It was low scoring though, and I think that's the blueprint to beating Georgia. Which brings me to my next take: Alabama's going to win the SEC. I don't think this Georgia team is going to beat Alabama. I don't even know. I'm not too confident about Georgia beating Ole Miss this week. We'll get to that later. Michigan takes care of business against the Dirty Cheaters down in West Lafayette. That's all I have to say.
Okay, Purdue sucks.
So I don't know if I said it on the show, but I had a dream last week. Oh no, it was after the show. I had a dream last week, nightmare rather, where I don't know where I was, but I look at the TV and Purdue's winning 17-3 at the end of the third quarter. I wake up, I'm like, oh my goodness, it's Thursday, thank God. And I'm kind of thinking, I'm like, is this a sign for something to come? No. So I'd send this to Sebastian. I was like,
I was really,
responsibly take this. And he's like, if you lose to Hudson Card, you're not actually Michigan. I was like, okay, okay, that's all I need to hear. Yep. So we're okay. My dreams are 0-1 right now. So I will keep you guys posted. Fade my dreams. Washington, USC.
Shootout.
Washington's a better team.
We knew that, but can we start a dialogue about how Caleb Williams is the most wasted talent in the history of college football? Because I don't ready. Here's my thing. The Caleb Williams story is going to be more of a tragedy than anything because he sprouted up at Oklahoma, did his job, what he came in the Red River rivalry game. Correct? That was his debut. It was against Texas. Okay. Sprouted up. Immediately, it was like, okay, this kid's a star. Follows his coach to USC. In what, the 2.5 full seasons that he's played, he's won one Heisman. He's never won a conference championship. That's official. They're not going to make it. He's never been to the playoffs, never even sniffed the playoffs. And he also lost to Tulane last year. So, like, wasted talent. I think it's similar levels of wasted talent to Randy Moss having to go to Marshall. I think that's the best comparison. Like, a generational talent. Except I'm not too confident about Caleb Williams translating to the next level. But that's more offseason talk from me.
Well, if we're talking about wasted talent, you better hope he doesn't go to the Bears because they'll just.
That same thing's gonna happen.
Yeah. Then it would be like even more of a tragedy.
Yep.
Go for it.
I have the stat on USC and Iowa.
Okay.
USC has allowed 224 points in the last 5 games.
Oh, I see where this is going.
Iowa has allowed 254 points in the last 2 years.
Wow. USC.
Just imagine USC or Iowa with either offense.
They should play. That should be a bowl game.
Yeah.
I need to see that.
I would not like to watch that.
Why?
Tell me why. I think he knows that Iowa would lose.
Iowa would be able to score 30, though.
I don't think so.
This is the worst offense I've ever seen.
This is the worst Iowa offense we've had.
I've ever seen.
Spencer Petras was better than Hill. Why do we always keep talking about Iowa?
I don't know, man. You brought up the stat.
You brought up Iowa.
I brought up the stat to explain USC and how bad their defense is. But
yeah.
I agree with their Caleb Williams take. He should have stayed at Oklahoma. I don't care if you're following your coach. Yeah.
Just imagine if they had a defense. That's just a subpar defense. I mean.
They need someone like a bad defense or like a decent defense like Illinois or something. So
okay, let's say we have a decent defense.
Yeah, so if they had Illinois' defense, they might be a little bit better.
Yeah, we have Johnny Newton, top 10 pick in the NFL upcoming draft.
All right.
Yep. No, what? I'm not wrong. Look at draft boards.
Let's cut this out.
Look at draft boards.
Oh my gosh.
Just getting to pick them.
Okay, what do you guys think of my Bama take though? I need this proofread.
No.
I didn't hate it.
I don't like it at all.
I just don't like Bama as a whole. So
neither do I, but I do think they are.
Georgia's way better.
Okay, but.
Way better.
There's concern. There's concern. I mean, and rightfully so. This Georgia team. Take it with a grain of salt. No Brock Bowers. But there's something fishy. I'm not too confident in them winning the SEC for the second year in a row.
Georgia is an NFL, like, just they have so much NFL talent.
This is not the same Georgia team I always see, though. I
agree with that.
I would say that usually when you watch a Georgia game, you're like, oh, this is a good team. This is a team that should just steamroll everybody until, like, the national championship.
Yeah, but, like,
I don't see that. They're in close games a lot more this season than they usually were.
As soon as you count them out, though, they just prove you wrong. Like, that's happened a couple of times this year. I was like, okay, maybe Georgia's not.
Okay, but keep this in mind. Last year, the two teams that played them the closest were Missouri and Kent State. No other team. Oh, and then Ohio State. Those are the three teams that played them the closest.
Just wait till Michigan finds them in the national championship.
I've been saying that same thing. Thank you.
Michigan. Hey, by the way, Michigan is, I think, by far the favorite. I think they should be the one seed.
I think they should.
Yeah, they should be number one right now.
Yeah.
But resume, the playoff committee is not consistent because it's resume for Ohio State because they do have one of the best, if not the best resume. And then for Georgia and Michigan, it's eye test. And then Florida State, it's a combination. And then Washington and Oregon, it's kind of like, well, Washington beat Oregon, and we just don't really feel like they're top four. And then it just so happens to work out where it's like, okay, then it's what? Then it's Texas, then Alabama, because Texas beat Alabama. And then it's what? Who comes after them?
I have
Ole Miss, because Alabama beat Ole Miss. Like, it works out perfectly like that.
Yeah, go Ole Miss.
Yeah.
Go Rebs, hottie toddy. All right.
Hottie toddy.
Pick 'em. I'm 38-16. Just want that out there. That is the best record.
Me and Kyron both missed 1 week, so.
True statement.
You're a little behind.
Yeah, we're a little behind.
I mean, we'll just go off win percentage. There's so many picks. Like, we'll just go off win percentage when it's all said and done with. First game, big noon kickoff. We are being robbed of. Well, first off, Penn State is too scared to make Michigan their whiteout game. But we are being robbed of a primetime game in Happy Valley. With that being said, Michigan will win, and they will win by a significant amount. Responsibly, this is my game of the year. For those of you who are new to the show or maybe didn't watch every episode, my first game of the year was Notre Dame to beat Ohio State, so I'm 0-1 looking for redemption. Game of the year. Michigan will win this game handedly.
Yeah.
Probably. Plain and simple. Plain and simple.
It's Michigan.
I mean, okay, yeah. We'll say it. We can't just like...
And the fact that Penn State dropped 51 on Maryland, I love that. I love that, because people are going to be like, oh, well, Penn State's a proven competitor. No, they're not. No, they're not. They looked like children against Ohio State, and Michigan makes Ohio State look like children, too. So it's a grandchild game. We're going to label it as
that. This is Michigan's first real game of the year, so that does draw maybe a little bit of concern, but they should win this game. I mean, Penn State played awful against Ohio State, so I don't expect them to do much better against Michigan. That's how I see it.
Correct.
Yeah.
It's a correct take.
Yep.
Game of the year. Actually, no. I think Michigan's going to handle them with ease. So,
well, I'm
I
saying it's my game of the year because I'm so confident.
Oh, I got you. I got you. I thought you were saying, like, this is going to be the
No.
Haven't
the,
been here.
No, the game of the year will be when Michigan meets Georgia and gets their revenge and Jim Harbaugh can walk off into the sunset. And by the sunset, I mean the Chicago skyline. Yeah.
Yeah, Michigan.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Pretty much. Hartford.
Michigan. I already said but yeah, go blue. Michigan.
All right.
Mizzou?
Next game.
Mizzou, Tennessee. Okay.
Why is this on here?
I'm so...
Mizzou.
It's two ranked teams. We got to keep it on there.
You're just
13 versus 14.
You're just listen.
No, it's not against Mizzou. It's just like Tennessee stinks.
Yeah,
like one of the worst
but it's Mizzou.
Teams.
If Campbell was here, he'd be saying like...
We have
watch
two
out for Joe
Mizzou,
Milton.
Possibly three, possibly four Mizzou academic... Weapons.
Academic weapons right at this table.
Coming to the school, coming to the town of Columbia, we have to support our school. That's
beautiful, sunny,
beautiful,
Como.
Sunny, beautiful, sunny,
Como, Columbia,
times.
Missouri, yeah. Columbia, So Mizzou's going to win this game from an unbiased standpoint.
Yeah.
They got what Tennessee doesn't, okay? Tennessee has the deep ball. They have a player named Squirrel White. Okay. That's it. Those are the only advantages they have.
Are you serious?
Squirrel White is awesome.
That's ridiculous.
And the best part about Squirrel White.
It's week 11 and you're just finding out about Squirrel White.
Squirrel White.
I never heard
of him. I love how they spell his last name too. Isn't it W-H-Y-T-E?
No.
I swear it is.
I think we're getting a little overboard with that. But yeah, Squirrel White. I think his real name's like Markavius. But
it's like a really like symmetrical face. It's like the mirror. I don't know. Clip it.
That's
that kind of funny.
Yeah, Missouri wins this game. I think we're all in agreement here.
M-I-Z.
We're all in a lot of agreement with pretty much all our picks. I might. No, whatever. We'll get that. ZOU.
There we go.
But yeah, the Tigers win this one pretty easily.
Easily.
Statement game. Missouri wins out. Yada yada. Okay, Washington, Utah. I'm gonna let you guys talk your talk first. See if it sways me a little bit. But right now, everyone's on Washington. Sebastian, go.
You got probably the best quarterback in the country. Utah. I mean, all right. Last time there, and not true.
That was
really quick. This last time Utah played a team like a top five team, they got blown out. So I don't expect anything different.
Okay, but
Washington's at home. Yeah, there's no way Utah.
That's the one thing. That's the one thing, because Washington played Oregon at home, won that game. Washington, since that game, has looked embarrassingly bad. They don't belong in the top 10 based on the way they've played since the Oregon win and the way Oregon's played since the Washington loss. They look like a top 2 team in the country.
Yeah,
but I think they're comparable to Michigan.
I just never really thought
span.
Utah was really just that good.
Yeah.
That's just me. That's just personal. I just don't really think.
I mean, part of it is just this Whittingham coach team. Like, they are very good. Bryson Barnes is so back.
Yeah, he's good, though.
They're coming off a game where they won by 52 points. That's a good morale boost for the offense, kind of let them know, like, hey, like, you guys can do this. Because there's been struggles, okay? I'm going to be honest with that. I'm not a Utah fan. There's been struggles with that offense. But I think they're kind of rounding into shape, and this will be it's going to be their biggest test behind Oregon, and obviously Oregon manhandled them at Autzen Stadium, so they're looking to avoid that. Or was that in Utah? That game might have been on the road, too, which makes
it... Yeah, it was in Utah.
Okay, no, that Utah. That makes it so much worse. The Oregon game?
I think it was in Utah.
Yeah, so...
Is Cameron Rising back?
No.
Doesn't matter.
Cam Rising's going to end up playing like a seventh year next year.
Yeah, didn't he take a red shirt?
I think he might have. Or if he hasn't, he will soon.
Here's what I'll say.
Okay.
Washington is going to win this game. Michael Penix Jr. will bounce back with Washington. And this offense will bounce back.
I agree.
More that I'll say about this is that you just brought it up. Oregon manhandled them.
Mm-hmm.
And so did Oregon State. Here's what else I'm going to say. I don't understand how Utah is ranked this high. UCLA has played close with them. Baylor's played close with them. Florida's played close with them. I don't think this is a great team.
Yeah. Couldn't agree more.
I think Washington will take this game, in my opinion, another with ease game.
Yeah, I agree.
I think Washington should win this game probably the same way Oregon did.
Utah is in that category of teams that shouldn't be.
I say Washington, but I mean, I don't think they have best quarterback. I think, like, there's probably some better. I think Bo Nix or Drake May might be better, but
not Drake.
No.
You just stop it right there.
I don't know, man.
I know we're talking about Washington and Utah, but I hate Drake May. I don't think he's that good. I think
hate is a strong word. I'd say
exactly. Yeah.
Not when I'm talking about Drake May.
All right.
Yeah.
Georgia Ole Miss.
Yeah, I'm sticking with the Utes. You guys couldn't sway me. I actually love the way I love the way this is being treated. No. Give me the
just
Utes.
Wait.
Give me the Utes.
Just wait.
You're gonna get embarrassed.
Just wait. You said Washington's gonna win similar
to Oregon.
To Oregon, they're gonna win 35-6.
I'll shake on that right now.
Okay, ready, right?
They're gonna get embarrassed.
What are the terms here? I think the final score will be.
Oh boy.
Final score time. Let's say
he doesn't want to do it. He doesn't want to shake your hand.
Just thinking about it.
No, I'm just trying to put a number out there. Don't flip the narrative.
I was gonna tell him when we go to Iowa, Illinois,
ready?
Okay.
30-27 Utah.
Oh boy.
Ooh.
That's not
shake gonna. His hand.
Okay, okay,
oh
if
boy.
That is the score,
shake his hand.
Yes. And Utah wins.
We can discuss terms, but yes.
But if Washington manhandles them,
okay. You can stop shaking hands.
Illinois jersey to Iowa game.
Ooh.
That's not a sin. That's
you
a
said
great
that,
thing.
You said that after. Come on.
I was trying to say it, but we already started the handshake.
We had the longest handshake ever because you would not let go of my hand. Hey, you wouldn't get your filthy paws off of me.
All right, this is what you
wearing an Illini jersey is an honor. It's a true honor.
No, it's
an
honor.
I was agreeing with you.
No, I'd feel gross doing that. I don't know. We can work the terms of that. But yeah, that does make things interesting. We will keep you guys updated, and we'll do something regarding that game. Georgia Ole Miss. I want to pick Ole Miss here.
So do I.
I really want to pick Ole Miss here. I mean, just this Kiffin team. Lane Kiffin loves offense, okay? Offense. I was going to say he loves to run the ball, but he's also got Jackson Dart, okay? This team can carve you up on the ground or through the air. It does not matter. The only concern is the defense, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And also the second half, because they did look really stale in the second half against Alabama. The game's at Georgia. Brock Bowers is still out, right? Yes.
They have 2 back-to-back home games?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh.
You can't bet against Georgia at home.
That's exactly why I
want to pick Ole Miss so bad with every bone in my body. But I'm not picking against Georgia. We're going to stick with the Bulldogs. They are going to win this game.
If this is at Ole Miss, this is a different story. I'm actually picking Ole Miss.
Same. I would agree. But it's not Georgia.
Georgia.
Yep. Give me Georgia.
I'm going to stick with Georgia.
Oregon, USC.
Side note, who do you guys think will be the heir to the Nick Saban throne at Alabama? I saw a tweet saying either Lane Kiffin or Mike McDaniel.
Mike McDaniel.
And I personally love I love both of those options.
Do you think he would leave? I mean, I don't.
The Miami Dolphins for Alabama.
Yeah.
I think Alabama pays their football coaches pretty nicely, so it's not off the table.
Aren't football coaches like the highest paid?
Yeah, football coaches are the highest paid state employees in like 35 states.
Yeah,
that's crazy. Right.
So
I don't think that's that crazy.
When Marcus Freeman leaves Notre Dame to be the Alabama head coach.
Yeah.
Why would you say that?
I mean, think about it. Tommy Rees.
He could have left Notre Dame when Brian Kelly left, but he decided to stay and become a head coach.
Well, obviously he's getting offered a head coach
some of
job.
The best classes in Notre Dame history. He's not leaving. That is just a terrible take.
Sure. So did McDaniel's making like 3.5 a year, right?
Yeah, Saban makes like 15.
Yeah. Well, yeah, because he's been there for so long.
Okay,
yeah.
Oregon, USC. Okay. Oregon, USC.
Oregon, come
Oregon.
On.
Yeah. We're obliged to have ranked games here, but Oregon is going to beat the brakes off of them.
Yep.
This is a game I think ends closer to 35-6.
Actually, I don't know why this game on here.
Because it's a ranked game. We always do ranked versus ranked.
Why is USC still ranked?
This game is USC still ranked.
Oh,
my goodness.
I was going on. Should we remove this game then?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Please.
Strike it from the record.
Please.
An interesting game, though. North Carolina Duke. What do we think happens there?
North Carolina wins.
I mean, I feel like that's not like we got to find a game to put on there.
Duke was close with FSU, though.
No, we're good. We're all good.
I think scratch that game. It's gone.
I think Duke might upset North Carolina, though.
We'll
put that as the Luke Martin maybe lock, probably don't take this of the week.
Just like the
Duke,
iffy, like
Duke
coin
to win.
Flip,
okay, NFL time.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Time for some good old National Football League.
Finally. What a week.
The Chiefs are okay, Kyron. We'll let our resident Chiefs fan kind of delegate this, but you guys are all right.
Wait.
You know, honestly,
are the Chiefs your main team or is the Bears your main team?
The Bears are my main team.
Okay, good.
But, you know, I'm a Royals fan, so I'm also a Chiefs fan.
Okay.
It's just how it works.
So Kansas City is just like your secondary
city. It's my second city.
All right.
Okay, here's what I'm going to say, though. I still don't feel confident in this Chiefs team.
Yeah, they're not winning the Super Bowl. I think
I think the Super Bowl is going to be 49ers Ravens.
No.
If the 49ers might make it.
Not 49ers, definitely not the 49ers.
But I think the Ravens are a lock for the Super Bowl in my
opinion. Ravens are the best team in football right now.
But this is what I'm going to say about the Chiefs Dolphins.
Either Ravens or Bengals.
The Chiefs game, it was good. I like that too. The you know, it was a fun game. But we shouldn't have won, in my opinion. I don't think we played up to par. But I also don't think this Dolphins team is very good.
Oh, yeah, Dolphins are frauds. I don't think they're going to make the playoffs.
Yeah, they're frauds.
I don't think they'll make the playoffs.
They can't beat a good team.
They beat the Panthers, the Patriots, the Chargers,
really,
the Giants, and then the Patriots again.
That's terrible.
And the Broncos.
Even worse.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
I think the Broncos game, that was when everybody started hyping them up, and then they didn't realize, like, oh, like, the Broncos actually suck. Like,
well, yeah, they lost 48-20 the next game to the Bills.
Yeah.
This Chiefs team is not.
They can't beat a good team.
Good.
Yeah, let's look ahead with them, too, but I'm pretty sure it's more likely than not that they are going to miss the playoffs, which is.
I think they will miss
the playoffs.
Which
is crazy.
I think they could
the
get
Dolphins.
In there. I don't think
no, 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 no. They'll be a wild card team.
They play the Raiders.
Win. Yes.
With the new interim, though, with Antonio Pierce.
Yes.
Win.
That is
win.
It's a culture change.
Win.
AOC, Aiden O'Connell.
Okay, he's actually good.
He's so good.
Aiden O'Connell
is actually good.
So good.
He was the Purdue quarterback, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. I always knew he was a
Raiders game, maybe. We'll say win, benefit of the doubt. At the Jets,
win.
Loss.
Win.
Loss.
Win.
Loss.
Win.
The Jets are a tough out.
Jets are terrible.
In the division,
their defense is good.
In the division.
Offense is terrible.
That's a tough out in the division.
They're just like Iowa.
Breece Hall.
Lost. They're 1-1.
Yeah. The Jets are just
at the
like
Commanders.
Iowa.
At the Commanders.
Loss.
That's a
loss.
Win.
That's
Wait.
I don't know. I
that's
feel
a
like
loss.
That's a,
I'm giving that one a loss.
Versus the Titans.
Win.
It's a win.
Loss.
They're
give
home.
Give me Levis.
Win. Yeah. Okay.
They're home. Win.
Versus the Jets. They're not going to get swept by the Jets. They win that. Cowboys
loss.
On
loss.
Christmas Eve.
Loss.
Big loss.
Yeah. Yes.
Big loss. Loss.
Cowboys are good, man.
So
love
what?
Cowboys
it's their year.
They're always
it's
not good. Their
and then,
they're
okay, wait, ready?
Good.
And then Ravens, Bills.
Loss.
So they
loss.
Go 3-5 on the way out. What's their record
nah,
right
they'll
now?
Make, they'll make it.
That's so, what, like 10-...
No, that's like 9-8.
You guys
yeah,
need to stop.
Right
I
yeah, it's 9-8.
The Jets are not a good team. Like I never said they were.
But I never said they were.
They're not a good team, but they're also not the worst team.
This is a great comparison though. The Jets are the Iowa Hawkeyes.
I think. I mean, do you even think
is they Aaron are Rodgers the Iowa?
Yeah, the Jets are the Iowa Hawkeyes. If they had, I'm trying to think, what would be like a good example, a good comparison?
If they had
Sam Hartman with a torn Achilles on the bench.
We do. We have Cade McNamara.
Oh boy.
No, Sam Hartman's way better than Cade. I'm sorry.
Can we stop talking about Iowa at this point in time? I'm tired of speaking of this Iowa team. I didn't bring Iowa into this one at all. All
right, moving on.
Josh Dobbs is that guy.
Yeah, he's solid.
He's a fun guy too. Like, you know, like the Kawhi Leonard, I'm a fun guy.
Yeah.
Like, Josh Dobbs.
Yeah. Boardman gets
Josh
paid.
Josh Dobbs is actually funny.
Oh yeah, Josh Dobbs is great.
Did you see what he said after the game? He's like, yeah, my goal for this week, like, I know we got the win, but my goal for this week is learning everybody's name. Yeah. Because
I only remember guys like Addison. So funny. Like, he, like, went out there, threw a touchdown. He's on the bench, and, like, one of his linemen goes up to him. He's like, oh, hey, like, I'm Matt, whatever. And he's like, Josh.
Yeah, like,
so, Josh Dobbs, great guy, the Pastronaut.
Yeah, he's an astronaut, right?
He got a master's at Tennessee or something.
Big fan.
He could work at NASA.
He had an
right
internship
now.
At yeah. NASA straight out of college and yeah. then signed an UDFA contract.
Insane.
So, yeah, great guy. We love Josh Dobbs around here. And Steelers. And
primarily
the AFC North is good.
I'm excited for JJ's to come back though.
The Super Bowl winner will come out of the AFC North.
Yeah, I think so too.
Okay.
Dobbs is actually good. I'm excited for JJ's to come
back. Actually, no.
We kind of skimmed over this, but the Bears lost by 7, and they lost the turnover battle 5-0. That should not be possible. Hey, I think that's the smallest
Montez
margin.
Montez Sweat effect. I mean, he didn't get a sack, but he actually generated a decent amount
and
of pressure.
And that has nothing to deal with turnovers.
I'm going to admit this publicly. Am I a bad guy for signing and starting Taysom Hill in my fantasy league?
Horrible.
I'm a horrible guy?
Yeah, it's kind of scum. Just,
he doesn't throw the ball, though.
Scum.
He doesn't throw the ball. He's just a tight
end that gets a lot of looks.
A tight end.
Okay.
Well, no, they don't give you the option to start him as a quarterback anymore. He's a tight end only.
Well, like, so, like it was.
But he doesn't throw the ball.
It was either last year or the year before.
I mean,
like,
didn't he throw a passing touchdown?
Yeah.
I left early because I couldn't watch the rest of this game, but
not
I'm pretty sure he threw a 3-yard passing touchdown.
Yeah, but for quarterbacks, that's 4 points.
He also caught a touchdown to a wide open
Juwan Johnson.
He also caught a touchdown and was the leading rusher for the Saints.
Are tight ends not allowed to catch touchdowns now?
Are they allowed to run the ball 11 times?
They can. If Arthur Smith is coaching, they might. Jonnu Smith, jet sweep, who knows?
He should be banned from fantasy.
I think I'm in the clear.
Unless he's a flex only.
It makes me so mad. I remember going against him the first time that they put him as quarterback, and he got like 30 points.
Yeah, that was
so annoying.
Oh,
I'm like, how did
this?
Because he was a quarterback the whole game.
Yeah.
But he was still put in as tight end, so the dude had two quarterbacks on his team.
Dang.
Yeah.
So dumb.
That's crazy.
Yeah, this is also not my first time doing it.
Yeah.
I did it a couple years ago.
Scum, dude.
Bears Saints.
Is what it is. Yeah, what about
Tyson Badgett? I know.
Fields
I
is
know,
out again this week.
I know. No, he isn't.
Doubtful.
Yeah.
He's just doubtful.
Bro, I was going to start him in fantasy.
Dallas Goedert's doubtful and he has a broken
Jared
arm. I'm pretty sure Fields is out.
Dallas Goedert has a broken arm.
I saw that.
I saw him walking him out.
He's getting surgery. I think he's out for like 4 weeks.
Wait, so I didn't, 4 weeks.
I didn't realize broken arms healed that fast.
Wait, who?
Yeah, I thought it was
like Dallas
Goedert.
No, it's a forearm. It's a forearm. Not whole arm.
Yeah, but it's still like...
I thought that like takes like 2 months to heal. Like, I thought it's like a whole like... You have to do like the cast and then like the thing after.
Hey, speaking
like,
of injuries, Aaron Rodgers might be back.
Yeah, Aaron Rodgers also might play, which breaks my brain.
Ridiculous. When are we ever going to talk about this Bears game?
Aaron Rodgers is a witch. What?
What
else is there that needs to be said?
I don't really want to. I don't know.
Tyson Badgett is not good. That's all I just
Cole
want
Komet.
To say.
I
think Tyson Badgett has played well enough to earn himself like...
He'll get a good role.
Maybe
with
like
this.
A
he'll,
high five or something.
He'll...
Yeah.
Not so much a Chase Daniel spot, but like he'll get an opportunity.
Mike Glennon.
Who?
Wait,
you're talking about
Tyson Badgett? Yeah.
Mike Glennon.
Whoa. Don't ever compare Mike Glennon to Tyson Badgett.
Mike Glennon, bro. Wasn't he
Tyson
on like 12
not that bad.
Football teams or something?
Tyson
like
Badgett had 4 turnovers.
Yeah, but don't compare to Mike Glennon.
Yeah,
Mike Glennon might be the worst.
Mike Glennon might
all
not have 4 turnovers in
don't
a game.
Don't compare those two men, bro.
Yeah, but Mike Glennon's going to throw like
Actually, let me search that up.
3 for 12, and then
I'm the biggest.
And then you're gonna sub in your running back.
Everybody is. I hate that dude. He looks so
dumb. Worst signing the Bears ever made was Mike Glennon. 3 years, $45 million, cut in like half the season. Like,
yeah, I mean, you can't really argue with that. I was trying to think of a rebuttal, but that's
Cole Kmet.
That's a factual
Cole
statement.
Cole Kmet is good though.
Yeah,
he's really good.
Yeah,
that catch he made with the shoulder across like the shoulder.
Dude,
like,
okay, I will say the Bears got guys. They have guys.
DJ Moore, yeah.
They need an offensive coordinator, a head coach, a defensive coordinator,
and Marvin Harrison Jr. And
that's
correct. You're doing the
Khalil
you're doing
Herbert's
the Shane
coming
Gillick
back too,
though.
Right?
We got guys out there.
Okay, I'm not wrong. We have good players.
One more thing about this Bears team.
Yeah.
Okay.
Or actually, more for Bears fans. You know, I was big on Darnell Mooney, but he had a good week. I'll give you that. He had a good week for the first time in a long time.
He hasn't been loud at all.
He has not been very good this year.
I think he's just overlooked by DJ.
No, I wouldn't even say that because
this is too much.
When you're in a good offense, you should be open more.
Yeah.
And play better. His weapons got better, like the people around him.
Mm-hmm.
So he should be better than what he is, and he's
and
not
also
really.
Chase Claypool's gone now too, so he should definitely have even more space.
Chase Claypool's not good.
He's not. I'm saying though, like he's like
yeah,
like literal.
But my
like,
thing about Darnell Mooney is that Bears fans were calling him the next Randy Moss and things like that. Ooh. Like
when?
Wait, you,
when
you don't remember this?
When?
Nope.
2 seasons ago, ooh. Like he had an insane season where he was just like mossing everybody.
Oh, is this with Trubisky or Fields?
It was with Trubisky, I think.
Okay, I know what you're talking about.
Oh, was this the one season where Trubisky did, like, insane and then he just fell off? Like,
but Mooney
didn't fall
playing.
Off. It just he got hurt and then, like, he's just
the
under
coaching,
now
yeah.
he's just underutilized.
And Mooney was playing
like.
Super good and they're like, just watch him be amazing. And then he just, he's gotten worse.
Well, he's still a good player. I'd love Darnell Mooney on the Bears. I hope he's a guy that stays with us.
I
see what you mean.
He's not loud enough, though.
I mean, he's got 307 yards this season. Just put that into perspective and think, hey, C.J. Stroud, who's a quarterback, I know it's different stats, but C.J. Stroud did throw for 450 yards in a game.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, C.J. Stroud has 14 touchdowns, one interception.
Insane.
This is
that's
season.
Really good.
All right, ready?
What's he ranked? What's his
In what?
In just, like, quarterbacks right now, like, with the
I mean, he's a top 8 quarterback, in my opinion.
All right.
No.
Wait. So, since Darnell Mooney's rookie season, he had 631 yards, 4 touchdowns. And the year after that, he had 1,000 yards, 81 receptions, 4 touchdowns. Everyone was like, oh, yeah, this is our guy. This is the future for wide receivers.
4 touchdowns in a season.
Last season.
Well, last year he got hurt. I do remember
him. Last season,
hurt.
He still only had 40 receptions and 493 yards, which is not good, even if he did get hurt or not.
Yeah. Last year was a really
good I mean, he only played maybe, how many games did he play? Like 15,
hey,
13?
I mean, just to remember really quick, I mean, Fields ran the ball every play last year, though.
Towards the end of the season,
okay,
he wouldn't stop.
And this year, we have been throwing the ball a little bit. And he has 20 receptions, 307 yards, and a touchdown.
All right, let's just move on.
Yeah.
Ravens, best team, I mean.
Yeah, no, the Ravens are, they're a really good team.
Absolutely insane.
You know, I've been saying this for a while. I've never understood a Lamar Jackson 8. This dude is awesome. He is a generational quarterback. Like, I love the guy. The stats may not show it because they run a lot with their running backs for touchdowns, but
I mean,
he is having an amazing season. He's throwing the ball. Like, I'm sure his completion percentage right now has got to be like over 70%. Because
we were saying though, like Seahawks have one of the best passing defenses in like the league right now, and they still.
Yeah.
Destroyed them.
I mean, that's not Devon Witherspoon. I mean, he only held Zay Flowers to one catch, 11 yards. So, I mean.
Right.
But besides that, I mean, Lamar Jackson is cooking up a really good Seahawks defense. And he's done this some numerous teams this year. He's by far.
We predicted.
He's a runaway MVP candidate right now.
We knew he was going to be amazing.
Okay.
We knew he was going to be amazing.
I mean, I alluded to it earlier. I think the Super Bowl champion is going to be either the Bengals or the Ravens.
I don't know about the Bengals. I mean,
I feel
see
like
them
the Bengals is still a little bit too early.
Bengals?
I want to see how they grow for the rest of the season.
Exactly.
Yeah,
exactly. Yeah. Because they beat the Bills, but the Bills are just such a
but
weird
the Bills
team.
Are just not a really good team either.
No,
the
they're
thing.
Not. They,
you know,
I've come to realize
that
now they're
just
not really
it
good.
It shifts way too much for the Bengals to say the Bengals are good right
this
now.
This might be a crazy take.
Okay. Yeah. Go for it.
But I do think the Cowboys... The Cowboys can make the Super Bowl.
No.
I think they do have a roster that's good enough to make a Super Bowl.
Yeah.
And I think Dak Prescott has been playing good, and I feel like the ways they've lost this season to good teams has been small things.
Yeah.
And I feel like I could see the Super Bowl ending up being Cowboys-Ravens.
I fundamentally disagree with that take, and I will not let that stand.
I don't think the Cowboys are ever capable of making the Super Bowl. I think they're just cursed. I don't think they can.
Yeah, I think it starts with Mike McCarthy. That's a start. That guy, you're not going to win a Super Bowl with that guy, and you weren't going to win one with Jason Garrett either. So, yeah, the Cowboys, there's pieces. There's definitely pieces there. Gallup, not great. Gallup is not great, okay?
Brandon Cooks, not.
Brandon Cooks is good.
Decent.
I mean, he's old. CeeDee Lamb is good. The defense is.
Martavius Bryant.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Welcome back.
In 2018, I would have been going crazy. I would have been like, oh, it's over. But
yeah, there was a run where I thought the Steelers were going to win the Super Bowl like every year. For probably, like,
he's
going to
have like a Julio Jones type role.
For one,
he's not that good, but yeah.
One more thing, the Super Bowl winner will come out of the AFC. The NFC is not that good.
Yeah, I could very well see Ravens. No, not Lions. But it's not going to be the Eagles. It's not going to be the Niners.
It's not going to be the Bills or Dolphins.
I mean, I could see the Lions. Lions or Cowboys are my two teams, right? I think
Lions or Seahawks, and we both know how they fared against the Ravens.
No, if I could choose four.
Geno Smith is not going to win a playoff game. I'm going to say that now. Geno Smith is not going to win a playoff game.
Drew Lock.
They need Drew Lock.
He's had a very mediocre season.
Actually, I'm going to disagree with you. I think the Eagles will make the Super Bowl. Just based off that they are the best team in the NFC pretty easily. And they're not as good as they were last year.
Okay.
I think A.J. Brown right now is the best receiver in the league. Right now.
He's been so consistent.
That's actually, I kind of like that take.
I like that take too.
Did we forget about number 10 on the Dolphins?
Tyreek.
Who might win MVP this season?
I'm saying right now.
I feel like Tyreek's kind of cooled down though.
No.
Yeah.
He's still significantly ahead of A.J. Brown.
But I'm talking pure impact, though. Like, Tyreek Hill, a lot of his best games are against Mickey Mouse teams.
Well, but do you understand how bad the Dolphins would be without him? The Eagles would still be good.
I don't know.
No, because the Eagles...
If Tua did not have Tyreek Hill...
The Eagles have not been great.
If Tua did not have Tyreek Hill...
He would have the same record without Tyreek Hill.
Tua is not good.
I wouldn't say
I'm going to say
that. Let's go pick him.
Pick him.
Something I want to point out, Jack Hartford, you are 17-21. Is that a typo?
This is our champion last year. What happened?
It happens when you miss maybe a week or so.
Hey, how about my record?
Yeah, I don't like that either. But our defending champ is currently the only one under 500.
I had an off year. You know what? Hey, you know what though? I could say it's switched. With fantasy, I'm doing amazing in fantasy.
People are speculating. Was Hartford's run last year for the championship? Was it
incredible?
Is there an asterisk on that run? Whatever. Bears Panthers.
Oh wait,
Sebastian. We have boots on the ground tomorrow night. Bears.
All you need to know is
go Bears.
As long as I'm at Soldier Field, the Bears will never lose.
He's like the beacon of hope.
On the beacon.
Would you say your record is at Bears games?
2-0.
2-0. Let's make it 3. Yeah, we're all in the Bears, and I think it more comes down to the Panthers being horrible. I'm not too confident about the whole Tyson Badgett thing. I don't know. Maybe that helps them out spread-wise, though.
Still have weapons, though, regardless. Panthers are awful.
I think. Hey, Khalil Herbert's back. Quan Brisker's back. Equanimous St. Brown is back. We got guys back. Mm-hmm. That's all. Okay.
This will be Bryce Young's best game of the season, though. I'm putting that out right now. This will be the best game of his season.
Yeah, I think the Bears win by at least a touchdown.
I think so too, but I think this will be Bryce Young's best game of the season.
I think both these teams, it's going to be relatively high scoring. High 20s for both.
We're going to go back and be like, remember when the Texans lost to the Jets or whoever it was?
The Panthers?
Yeah. It'll be just like this. Like, oh, the Bears beat the Panthers and now they get the numbers 2 pick.
Oh, you're talking.
What game was that?
Yeah, Colts. Texans beat the Colts.
Yeah.
Yep. Okay. Ravens, Browns. We're all on the Ravens. I do think this is going to be a very close game, though.
Miles Garrett.
Actually, we're all on the same team for most of this. Bengals, Texans. We're all picking the Bengals.
Yep.
Keeping it nice and tidy. I do have a take for when we're done with the pick 'em. Jags, Niners. 49ers except 49ers. Kyron. Kyron has to. He's saying Jags have a chance. What do we think about that?
I think the Jags do have.
Well,
a chance.
I think the Jags have a chance.
Well, no, Jags have a chance. Is over.
That's true.
Yeah.
Moment of silence for our.
For Jags have a chance.
For Jags have a chance.
Yep.
All right. So.
Okay, there we go.
I think the Jags will sneak away with a win here. I think this game will be close. I think Trevor Lawrence is turning into a top five quarterback in the league.
No.
He will be a top five quarterback in the league in the next year or two.
You see the like the face swap with him and Peyton Manning?
Yeah, that was
hilarious. Yeah. Hilarious.
And maybe accurate.
Wait, I kind of want to see that now. Wait.
Yeah. Yeah, the Jaguars posted it because he was on the Manning cast on Monday.
But this game is mainly picked for me because I just don't think the Niners are as...
Yeah, I'm not too sold on the Niners either. Yeah. They were my preseason Super Bowl team, but there's been some hiccups here and there. Obviously, three losses in a row.
I think Debo is back this week, though.
Yeah.
That's huge.
That helps me out.
Not worried. Jags. Okay.
Last game, Bucks-Titans. Yeah. Yeah. Bucks-Titans.
That's good.
I like Will Levis a lot. I also like Baker Mayfield a lot. This is one of those spots where it's like two like decent quarterbacks going at each other, and I'm just like, nice. Like I'm not cheering for any one team, but I do think the Titans are the better team in this spot, which begs the question: who's going to win the NFC South?
Ooh,
NFC South,
Falcons.
Falcons. Whoa. Yeah. Okay, I'm with the Falcons.
Hey, you know what? I think the Falcons need Taylor Heineke as their quarterback.
Yeah, if Heineke's their quarterback, they will win.
Yes. Yeah. If it's Desmond Ridder, no way.
Yeah.
No way.
Mm-hmm. They'll realize.
Yeah. Although, and I think Arthur Smith is, like, I like him, but he's got to use
Pitts and Bijan. So,
yeah, sometimes he's just trying too hard. Like we mentioned at the Jets seat with Jonnu Smith on the goal line when it's like, hey, you spent the fourth overall pick on Kyle Pitts. Might be nice to use him, you know?
Eighth, correction.
Eighth?
Yes.
Yeah, it was eighth. Sooner.
And then Bijan was a first rounder as well, early first rounder.
Seven,
thank you.
Drake London.
10th overall. Drake London.
Yeah.
I'm still convinced he was, well.
I think he's a dog.
At the time,
he's good.
At the time, I thought he was the best receiver in his class. I'm blanking on who's in that class, though. That could be a very
Chris Olave.
EJ
Olave. What?
Definitely not DJ Moore.
No, EJ Moore.
EJ Moore? He's way better than EJ Moore.
No, yeah, I'm saying Elijah.
Elijah. Elijah Moore.
Yeah, Moore, EJ yeah. Moore on the, Elijah Moore on the Browns. Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
This is Drake London's second.
Garrett Wilson's.
Season,
right? Hey,
Garrett Wilson.
Garrett
yeah.
Wilson's better than Drake London. Yeah.
That's the best.
Fair. Okay. I think that just about does it. My last take. All five of the NFL games we picked, every single one of those will be a one-score game. Everyone. Oh.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. No, that's fine. Yeah.
I'm very confident about the winners, but I do think every loser in this scenario is playing till the final whistle. Like, there might be a Hail Mary thrown in like three of these games.
I would agree.
I don't think that's outrageous at all.
Okay.
I picked what? Panthers, Browns, Texans, Jaguars, and Buccaneers to lose. I think all those teams can play tight, though. All
right, here's the most wild thing I'm going to say.
Okay, wild fact of the day.
49ers and Jags will end in a missed field goal to tie the game.
By Moody. Wow. By Moody. By Moody. All right.
Moody stinks.
Okay.
Moody's good.
No.
I saw his I saw his debut, yeah. Against Indiana, he had five field goals.
Wow.
Yeah. The overrated. That's a bad offense. For, Jake Moody.
Okay. That is...
That's it.
That's all we got. Sure. Quick, college football or college basketball champion?
All right, I'm going to go with Duke.
Boo!
USC?
Kansas.
USC is my runner-up.
You still pointing at me?
Yeah. UConn is not going to repeat, but I blanked, and I did not want to pick Duke or Creighton or Houston, which that kind of rounds out my final four.
Should have just rocked
final
with
four?
USC.
Actually, you know what? I'm going to change my pick. Mizzou.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Sean East had a great game.
Yeah, he's going to do it. Yeah.
Sean East had a great game. Dennis Gates, runner-up to Coach of the Year behind Dan Hurley, because Dan Hurley is the best coach in college basketball, and there's no one touching him right now. That's all we got. Thank you for watching. We will see you next Wednesday. As always, Luke Martin, Sebastian Dimter, Kyron Ross, and Jack Hartford.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you so much. And, yeah.
Your 2023 national champion, Illinois Fighting Illini.
Clip that.